shortly after I got going with Calder, the Vietnam War came on, and I became very vociferously opposed to it. It didn't make any sense to me that we should go to war 10,000 miles away over a very nebulous reason. I just became a member of the draft board. But as the war went on, I kept insisting, leading candlelight parades or reading the names of the dead. Draft board that I was serving on was giving too many deferments to people that were conscientious objectors. And the New York Times published a front page article on the draft board that was riling things up in New Canaan. House and Garden saw that, and the editor said, Pedro Guerrero is not to ever do another thing for us. And that was after 20 years. That was a big blow. That was one way they could get to me, destroy my ability to make a living.
I think there's no question that this had a decisive influence on Pete's career direction, away from being an assignment photographer and prompting him now more fully to the great long-term artist documentation projects that occupied the last portion of his life.